Dean, thank you. On Close Up this morning, the Supreme Court rejects what appears to be the final appeal from Terry Schiavo's parents. Father Frank Pavone saw Terry Schiavo in person on Wednesday. He is a spiritual advisor to her parents. Father Pavone, good morning. Nice to have you here.
Thank you, Matt. It's good to be with you.
Tell me a little bit about your visit to Terry at that hospice yesterday. How would you describe her condition?
I was with Terry for about 2 hours up until midnight last night. And I would dispute any characterization of her as dying peacefully and with dignity. She is obviously being starved and dehydrated, and she looks it. Her breathing is very rapid and shallow. Her face is sunken. Her eyes are open. Her eyes are oscillating back and forth fairly rapidly. Matt, I visited her on two previous occasions before the feeding tube was removed. She was very responsive. That's when she was peaceful. She laughed, she smiled, she returned her dad's kiss. And when I laid my hands on her to pray with her, this was back at the beginning of February, she closed her eyes while I said the prayer. And when I finished the prayer and lifted my hands off her head, she opened her eyes again and focused them on me.
I'm curious about your visit yesterday. Was it strictly a personal visit, or were you asked to perform some duties as a priest by her family?
No, it was more along the lines of a personal visit. The family put me on the visitors list some years ago, and it was in that context I was together with Bobby, her brother, and of course with Suzanne, her sister. And we prayed. We just sat there, and sometimes in silence, sometimes just caressing her head, sometimes singing. And we prayed the rosary and other prayers that Terry was used to during the year.
For doctors have said that even if the feeding tube were reinserted today, Father Pavone, she probably has sustained enough damage over these last 12 days where she could not reach the level of function that she had even a week ago. Is that something her parents fully understand?
Well, of course, the medical diagnosis is for the medical professionals. The family has this attitude that whatever level of functioning our daughter has, she's still our daughter, and life is valuable even when it's impaired. We have a battle here not just of medical opinions. We have a battle here of philosophies, of worldviews. And the question our nation faces right now in front of this little hospice in Florida is whether or not we're going to establish in this country a separate caste of people that we regard as disposable because they're impaired. The family are not medical experts, of course, but they have a lot of love.
There have been hundreds of protesters outside that hospice in Pinellas Park over the last weeks. And I mean, even this morning we read in the paper where there's a husband and wife Christian juggling team out there. I mean, to say in some ways it's become a circus is not an overstatement. Do you think, what percentage of the people, and I know you've talked to some of those people outside that building, what percentage of those people are there for Terry, and what percentage are there to advance some other kind of agenda?
Well, there is a deep personal concern on the part of all the people who are here, young and old alike. I know one person who was here a few days ago was herself a Holocaust survivor, and she had been starved and survived and tried to bring Terry a cup of water. There are two things going on here at once. There's the personal concern, but also there is a legitimate cause to be advanced here, and it's the cause of the sanctity of life. Which is why I'm involved in this situation. We at Priests for Life advance that mission, which is nothing other than the idea that every patient, no matter what their level of functioning, deserves humane care, and that feeding is not a medical treatment. When we come back from dinner, we don't say, oh, I just had my latest medical treatment. Well, what we're seeing here is a redefinition of such basic things as food and water as being somehow medical treatment and sometimes extraordinary medical treatment. That's not the case at all.
Father Frank Pavone. Father Pavone, we appreciate your time this morning. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Thanks for all you do.